Breaking right now at 5, yet another local death in the recent meningitis outbreak. Good evening. I'm Jim Payne.
I'm Martha Sagalski. That brings the total number of those killed in Central Florida to 3. We're also learning that there are 45 local facilities that received products from the New England pharmacy linked to the outbreak. You can see that full list scrolling at some point on the bottom of your screen. WESH News' Gail Pascal Brown joining us live in the Breaking News Center with the story. Gail.
Well, what we want you to know is the news today, according to some local health officials, is worse because more people could be affected. Now, this new list that came out contains those facilities which have received the products in general. I spoke with a state health expert, and she has information you need to know.
The Centers for Disease Control has updated a list of all the healthcare facilities nationwide which have received products from the New England Compounding Center. There are 260 facilities, up from the previous 78. How does that break down in Central Florida? We now have 45 facilities that received NECC products. We're not saying those products are contaminated. I spoke with state epidemiologist Dr. Karina Blackmore by telephone.
Why didn't we just give that whole list in the beginning?
So again, the list became available to us just the other day, although we knew already on October 6th that the drugs were recalled. So, I mean, that's the typical process that FDA uses.
She does add, with the new list, which includes plastic surgery facilities, eye and dermatology offices, as well as hospitals, there are no new cases.
And we do not actually have any human disease associated with these other types of injection. It's a precautionary notice that is based on this ongoing investigation that FDA has conducted since the end of September.
The best advice, she says,
to keep an eye on your own health and make sure you stay in touch with your health care provider. That's what's important.
WESH 2 News has spent the last several hours calling local facilities named on that CDC list. Now, we didn't get in touch with all of them, but the ones who did talk with us often said the same thing. The products in question are mostly ointments or numbing creams. All said, they have already quarantined those products. Jim, Martha.